Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you a curious behavior of Dax that has to do with case sensitivity. Now, Dax is case insensitive, meaning that two strings, if they differ only because of the casing, they are considered identical. This is good whenever you build reports, because if you store the name of somebody, no matter whether it's lowercase, uppercase, or a mixture of the two, it always considered equal and it's merged together, so it's good when you build reports. With that said, if you do not pay attention to this detail, you might end up doing calculations that produce strange results when you mix lowercase and uppercase strings in the same table, because this happens only when you create tables. And in order to understand the demos that I'm going to show you later, I need a bit of introduction to understand and to explain you how Dax actually stores information. Now, let me show you this. Here I created a table that contains several names: Alberto, Marco, Daniele, and so on. And these are strings. But the table that we create with strings is not actually stored with strings. The engine does a different work. It says, well, first thing that I need to do is build a dictionary. To build a dictionary, it scans the table, goes on the first line and says, hey, I found Alberto. So I add Alberto to my dictionary and I replace Alberto with one because it's the first string that I find. Then I go farther and I find Marco. That means I add another row, I name it Marco, and I replace this with not one, but two, Marco. Then I go farther and I find Daniele, and the process goes on. So I add the row three, Daniele, and I replace this number with three. And here comes the interesting part, because now I find Daniele again. And because I found Daniele and it's already here, I do not need to add anything to the dictionary. I simply replace Daniele with three, Alberto with two, and Marco with one. Now, the structure that Dax actually stores is the upper one, only numbers that reference the dictionary. But the important detail is that in order to decide whether a row needs to be added or not to the dictionary, the engine checks for equality. So it checked if this instance of Daniele was already present here. And because it found it, then it did not add it to the dictionary. This comparison, the check for the presence of a row in the dictionary, is case insensitive. Therefore, if the dictionary contains a different version of the same string with a different cases, it will not create the entry and it will replace the string with the value that was already present in the dictionary. And that creates some problems. Now, let's go to the demo and see what happens with some Dax code. I have created this query, where I have two tables that I define here. Letters upper that contains an uppercase A, an A, lowercase A, and then a lowercase B. Whereas letters lower contains a lowercase A, an uppercase A, and then a B, uppercase. Now, if you evaluate letters upper, as I'm doing right now, I need to connect the right way. I'm connected with the wrong model. Okay, now if I run letters upper, you see that already something strange happens. I have A uppercase, A lowercase, and then B. The engine created the first entry in the dictionary, which is uppercase, then it checked for the second letter, which is a lowercase A, and instead of inserting lowercase A, it uses uppercase A, because that's the first A that it found in the dictionary, whereas for the B, it uses the lowercase. So, you store a table containing values, you think that these values are uppercase or lowercase depending on what you write, but that's not what actually the engine stores. The engine uses the first casing version of the string, and then it replaces all the next ones with the first that it found. We have seen that with the first table. Let's do with the second table, letters lower. Letters lower is slightly different because now we have a lowercase a first, then an uppercase a, and then a b. You can try to guess that. The first will be lowercase a, the second will be replaced by the first, and the uppercase b will remain where it is. And if I run the query, you see the result is lowercase a, then lowercase a again, and then uppercase b. Now, it's interesting to see what happens if we manipulate this table. What if we union them, we intersect them, or we do other operations? The algorithm is always the same. The first occurrence of a string is the one that rules and defines the casing of all the next ones. Let's see that. If I do a union of letters lower and letters upper, because letters lower is the first table, the first a is lowercase, so I would expect these to become lowercase, but also the next ones, the one from letter upper, will all be lowercase. And if we run it, you see that the results contains lowercase a everywhere, whereas the b is uppercase because the first instance that we found was uppercase. If you exchange the order, and you use letters upper first and letters lower later, what happens is now the a is uppercase. Now, this is not a big problem because at the end the strings are absolutely identical, but it is important because you might think that you are processing a table and doing some operations, but what is stored in the model is actually something different. Let me show you that with another example. Now, what if we define a new table that we compute? So we have letters upper, we have letters lower, we define a variable, all lowercase, where I use select columns from letters upper, and I create a new row, new column, lower a, that uses the lower function. Now, lower always returns a lowercase letter. Let me gain some space. So all lowercase uses lower. Therefore, even though the first a is uppercase, that will become lowercase. And if I evaluate all lowercase and I run it, I get an error because, yes, I messed up everything here. Select columns, lower a. Okay. Not yet, comma missing. Okay. You see that lower a has everything which is lowercase. So you might conclude that all lowercase works fine. But as soon as you union your all lowercase with letters upper, because in letters upper the first letter is uppercase, the first A is uppercase, despite my all lowercase putting everything in lowercase, the result will contain the A which are still uppercase. So what happens is that when you just run a query or you get the result from a table function, you still have the original result. But as soon as this result is pushed inside a table, then the engine will build the dictionary, will remove duplicates, and it will use the casing of the first letter. Now, this is, as I said, not a big problem whenever you work with names. If it's a product name or if it's a customer name, that is not a big issue. If that was a code, like a product code or an internal code where casing matters, then this might be a problem because all the different versions of the same string will be matched together. Now, if you are working with Power BI, either the Power BI service, the Power BI service or Power BI Premium or Power BI Desktop, you have no options. Dax is always case insensitive with Power BI. If you're working with analysis services, there you have the option of choosing a collation that is case sensitive. If that is the case, you set up analysis services that way, at that point uppercase A and lowercase A, they will be considered differently. There will be two strings separated and you will not have this problem. You will have the problem that you need to worry about casing whenever you use names or other kind of strings. With that said, I strongly advise if you have codes in your model that are case sensitive, replace them with something different before importing them in Power BI. And always work with case insensitive comparison, because even though you might be using Power, you might be using analysis services and your reports work fine, if your users extract information from your model and build their own Power BI data model to do further analysis, they will have the problem and they will have no way and no knowledge to understand where the problem comes from. So try to avoid the problem of case sensitivity first by being aware of the issue, and once you understood that, get rid of it by using always case insensitive comparison, and if case sensitivity matters for your codes, handle that by replacing them with integer values or doing some ETL step to clean up your data. Enjoy, guys!